Hello all, I am Mudit Jain, ex-IPS, ex-IRS. Welcome to this first evaluation session of Mains Ready by December program. Mains Ready by December is our free for all initiative wherein we guide you with respect to mains preparation so that you can feel ready by the month of December that you are confident कि अब मेरा प्रीलिम्स हो गया, लाओ मेंस का पेपर, मैं मेंस के बढ़िया आंसर लिखता हूँ. दैट इज आवर फ्री फॉर ऑल इनिशिएटिव विच वी रन ऑन टेलीग्राम, द लिंक ऑफ विच इज अवेलेबल इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन सेक्शन. सो हम इस ग्रुप में प्लानर देते हैं, हम इस ग्रुप में नोट्स मटेरियल सब कुछ देते हैं, साथ में क्वेश्चंस देते हैं, एंड देन द स्टूडेंट्स पोस्ट देयर आंसर्स बाय द एंड ऑफ द डे. एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट इवेल्युएशन सेशन ऑफ एथिक्स आंसर्स रिटन बाय सच स्टूडेंट्स. ठीक है. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन योर स्क्रीन इज वन ऑफ द टेस्ट ऑफ इंटेग्रिटी इज कंप्लीट रिफ्यूजल टू बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड. एक्सप्लेन विद रेफरेंस टू रियल लाइफ एग्जांपल्स 150 वर्ड्स 10 मार्कर क्वेश्चन ऑफ एथिक्स सेक्शन ए. ठीक है. एनी एथिक्स सेक्शन ए क्वेश्चन शुड बी स्टार्टेड विद डेफिनेशन ऑफ कीवर्ड. सो द कीवर्ड हियर इज इंटेग्रिटी एंड इट हैज बीन राइटफुली स्टार्टेड विद डेफिनेशन ऑफ integrity. So this is good aspect about this question. Now the person has, I'll not of course name the student because that does not look good. So what the person has now done is he has mentioned features with respect to uncompromised virtues of integrity and has written 3 or 4 points, 5 points, 3-liner each. ठीक है. एंड देन देर इज अ रियल लाइफ एग्जाम्पल, वन एग्जाम्पल दैट इज स्ट्रेस्ड टू 8-9 लाइन्स एंड देन देर इज अ कंक्लूजन विद अ कोट. नाउ लेट मी टेल यू वॉट आइडियली यू शुड हैव हैड इन दिस क्वेश्चन. दिस इज फाइन दैट द आंसर हैज बीन स्टार्टेड विद इंटेग्रिटी, बट द क्वेश्चन स्टार्टेड विद वन ऑफ द टेस्ट ऑफ इंटेग्रिटी. So you not only have to mention various tests of integrity or you have to establish how integrity means complete refusal to being compromised, but what are the other tests of integrity that also should have been mentioned. Further, when there is a reference, there is a direction that you have to give example. So please trust me on this. Not just one example will work, you have to write at least 2 examples. That I have guided throughout my courses to students as well, that please make a habit of writing 2 examples in ethics paper. I have done that in 4 mains, I have cleared them all, so you can trust me on this, that 2 examples are needed. Plus, one more thing that I did not find right in this answer is that 5 points are written and again only 1 example, so 2 examples should have been there, plus there is no diagram. Now as per me, 1 diagram is equal to plus 1 mark, and there are 11 to 12 different types of diagrams that can be easily drawn in ethics paper, as we'll also see in coming answers. But the question, but the this particular answer does not have a diagram and hence this is not complete. 5 points ki jagah you could have written 4 points. 4 points are more than enough in ethics paper. There should have been 2 examples. Examples should be of max 3 or 4 lines each, not more than that. And that could have saved you enough space to draw any diagram. For example, you could have drawn a simple hub and spoke, other tests of integrity, and you could have drawn 4 spokes and mentioned other tests of integrity, and that would have made this answer a complete one. ठीक है. Let us now move on to the second structure or answer. So this question reads, apart from innovativeness and creativity, a civil servant is also required to imbibe values of interdependence and adaptability. Explain in light of evolving roles of civil servants in India. So now before moving on to the answer, let me tell you what ideally the structure should be. In the light of evolving role of civil servants, you have to tell how interdependence, adaptability, creativity and innovativeness are required. And more focus should be on these two, because the question says apart from this and this, these two are required. Now there are four keywords as also highlighted by this student: innovativeness, creativity, adaptability and interdependence. I cannot define all four, and all four are equally important. But what I can do is I can relate them with foundational values chapter, aptitude and foundational values. So I'll give a generic introduction of foundational values of civil services, or I can mention the evolving role of civil servants in the introduction itself. Now let us see if the concerned student has addressed this demand or not. The answer has started with definition of interdependence and then adaptability. Then in the modern democratic institution, civil servant deal with ample sector like. Theek hai, so better than this should have been, you will tell the traditional role of civil servants in one or two lines, not more than that. And then you will mention the current role, that the current role is not only restricted to policy implementation, but you give advices in as policy formulators as well. You are advisors on various policy formulations. Plus, you are not a tax. You are a tax facilitator now. You are not a tax enforcer. So the role is shifting towards facilitation. Role is shifting towards being advocate for the rights of the marginalized. You could have mentioned that. Because the question says evolving role. So I have to explain. के रोल इवॉल्व हो कैसे रहा है, पहले क्या रोल है वो तो बताऊंगा, तभी रोल बता पाऊंगा कि इवॉल्व कैसे हो रहा है, तो वो नहीं बताया इस एस्पेक्ट में. प्लस इंट्रो आई थिंक शुड हैव बीन रिटन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू फाउंडेशनल वैल्यूज, क्योंकि नाउ यू हैव पिक्ड टू डिफरेंट वैल्यूज एंड डिफाइंड देम, बट वॉट अबाउट दीज टू वैल्यूज, इनोवेटिवनेस एंड क्रिएटिविटी, यू हैव नॉट डिफाइंड देम. नाउ लेट अस सी इफ दीज एस्पेक्ट्स आर कवर्ड और नॉट. So the person has mentioned role of interdependence and adaptability in civil services, and there are pointers. Okay, there is one example, two examples. Okay, two, three examples are there. Five points have been written. The role of these two have been clubbed. Now what I would have done is, so the question does not say that these two are not required. Till now I cannot see any answer with respect to these two. So even if the more focus is on adaptability and interdependence, I have to mention about innovativeness and creativity as well. The concerned student has missed the complete demand of the question, because the entire focus on these are on these two values. I'll tell the traditional role, then I'll tell the evolving role, then I'll say I'll write 1 point for innovativeness, 1 point for creativity. But as I already stated that more focus should be on this, I'll write 2 points each. I'll give example for this as well. I can give one example for interdependence, one example for adaptability, and 2 points each. That would have met the complete demand of the question. Okay, this can be treated as a diagram, but then that demand of the question is missing. As I already stated, this is the third question. What are the major teachings of Guru Nanak? Explain their relevance in contemporary world. I remember this question was asked in latest mains, that is 2023 mains. So let us see if the structure that I'll write is, of course, there are simple two parts of this question. I'll write about the major teachings of Guru Nanak ji in 3-4 points. If I have more teachings with me, then I could draw a diagram, maybe a hub and spoke or a flowchart diagram. Then the second part of the question is explain their relevance in contemporary world. So I'll write the relevance with respect to the current happenings. Tabhi contemporary world explain ho payega. Ab dekhte hain unhone kya likha hai. He has started with a quote related to Guru Nanak ji. Then guiding principles are, okay, this is completely wrong way to write answer. Answer have to be written in points, and those 2 points should be in separate lines and not in a paragraph form. This is as good as a paragraph. I am not sure why this answer has been written in this manner. It should be numbered in points. Now this is a 10 marker question, an easy one. I can write three teachings and I can draw a diagram with respect to other teachings, or I can draw a flow chart with respect to other teachings, or there are other diagrams as well that that can be drawn here. So even though the points are right, this is not the correct way of presenting them. Then the relevance in contemporary world, okay, honest life, honesty in relationship, at business, public life, workplace, okay, it is a generic point. Equality, treating everyone equally irrespective of caste, creed, gender will foster humanity. The points appear to be generic. What rather should be done is, when it has asked you to explain the relevance in contemporary world, you should mention contemporary issues. For example, real life examples of corruption. Ke abhi ghat koper pe ek holding gira hai. So I should link it with honest living and honest earning, that it is not in line with honest living and honest earning. In recent times, India has given budgetary support to countries like Maldives, etc. Abhi budget mein aapne dekha hoga. So link it with daan, daya, compassion and all. Ki hum budgetary support de rahe hain, aid de rahe hain, grants de rahe hain. So real life examples likhne the, but I cannot see real life examples in this answer. These are all generic keywords which have been molded in form of answer, and again the diagram is missing. Okay, next is, what do you understand by the term dedication to public service? How is civil service different from other services? Okay, so there are two parts of question. Pehle toh dedication to public service kya hai? You will tell the meaning and you will explain it with one example. Because aisa nahi hoga ke you only mention the meaning and move on to the next part. You have to explain it with help of one example at least. And then you will tell the other part of the question, that is, how is civil service different from other services? So you have to mention couple of other services, like say emergency responders, disaster management, or health workers, or fire department, and so on. These are also other services, and how they are different from civil services per se, civil servants. Okay, so the answer has been started with a quote. ठीक है, कोट बढ़िया है, टैगोर की कोट है. द आंसर इज इन पैराग्राफ, एंड एज आई हैव टोल्ड मल्टीपल टाइम्स अक्रॉस माय सेशंस एंड द वीडियोस अवेलेबल ऑन यूट्यूब, आई हैव क्लियरली स्पेसिफाइड दैट दिस इज नॉट द वे टू राइट आंसर. एज यू वुड ऑल्सो सी ऑन द स्क्रीन के व्हेन यू राइट आंसर इन पैराग्राफ, यू टेंड टू डाइग्रेस फ्रॉम द डिमांड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. अब यहाँ पे डेफिनेशन डायरेक्ट अब तक नहीं आई है कहीं भी. इनडायरेक्टली जॉय, कंफर्ट, इरेडिकेटिंग इश्यूज वगैरह पे फोकस है. डेडिकेशन टू सर्विस पूछा गया है, उसकी एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन नहीं है कि एज पर दिस डेडिकेशन टू पब्लिक सर्विस ये होता है, वो एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन नहीं आई है. कोर्ट से शुरू हुआ है, ठीक है. सो दिस इज अ प्रॉब्लम. पीपल थिंक दैट दिल राइट अ कोट एंड देन दैट विल इम्प्रेस द एग्जामिनर और जॉब हो जाएगी. एथिक्स में ऐसा नहीं है. ट्रीट इट लाइक एनी अदर जीएस पेपर. स्टिक टू द डिमांड ऑफ द टॉपिक एंड आंसर वॉट हैज बीन आस्क्ड रैदर देन वॉट यू नो, वॉट यू फील इज राइट. सेकेंड पार्ट है, हाउ द सिविल सर्विसेज आर डिफरेंट. ओके, डिफरेंसेज इन्होंने स्टेक होल्डर फॉर्मेट में लिखे हैं, अदरवाइज द एक्सेप्टेड फॉर्मेट इज टेबुलर डिफरेंसेज लाइक वी यूज टू डू इन स्कूल्स. ठीक है, opportunity to bring change, difference in scope coverage, high level of public support. The points are generic, as you can see, because the concerned aspirant has failed to mention other services. कि कौन सी services से compare कर रहे हो, वो ही नहीं लिखा है. Generic points लिख दिया, opportunity to bring change, वो तो दूसरी service पे भी होता है. Very high level of responsibility, वो तो दूसरी service में भी होता है. Disaster management हो गया या fire safety services हो गई, health workers हो गए, responsibility तो उनकी भी होती है. You had to mention this in context of the civil services versus other services rather than generic points. So demand of the question is not met here as well. Next is, gratitude makes sense of our past, brings peace for today, and creates a vision for tomorrow. Bring out what it means to you in present context. ठीक है, ये एक quote based questions है. कोर्ट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन में क्रोनोलॉजिकल टाइप ऑफ कोर्ट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन है विच नीड्स टू बी आंसर्ड इन फॉर्म ऑफ अ क्रोनोलॉजी दैट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. सो ग्रेटिट्यूड बेक सेंस ऑफ आर पास्ट विल बी माई फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द कोर्ट. ब्रिंग्स पीस फॉर टूडे सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द कोर्ट के पास्ट का एक पार्ट हो गया, एक पार्ट हो गया टूडे का. एंड क्रिएट्स अ विजन फॉर टूमोरो. सो हाउ ग्रेटिट्यूड इफेक्ट्स द पास्ट, टू पॉइंट्स ऑन दैट. हाउ ग्रेटिट्यूड ब्रिंग्स पीस फॉर टूडे, टू पॉइंट्स और वन पॉइंट फॉर दैट. एंड हाउ इट क्रिएट्स अ विजन फॉर टूमोरो, अगेन वन और टू पॉइंट्स फॉर दैट. एंड ओवरऑल टू एग्जाम्पल्स नीड टू बी रिटन विद कीवर्ड्स एंड विद डायग्राम्स. ठीक है, अब इसमें देखते हैं कीवर्ड्स लिखे हैं नहीं, बिकॉज कीवर्ड्स आई हैव नॉट फोकस्ड ऑन कीवर्ड्स टिल नाउ इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज इट इज स्टिल ईजी टू राइट कीवर्ड्स इन अदर क्वेश्चंस, बट कोर्ट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन में ज्यादातर लोग कीवर्ड्स भूल जाते हैं लिखना. सो द कीवर्ड हियर इज ग्रैटिट्यूड एंड राइटफुली ही हैज स्टार्टेड विद डेफिनेशन ऑफ ग्रैटिट्यूड. इट इज अ सेंस ऑफ थैंकफुलनेस टूवर्ड्स एनी साइकोलॉजिकल ऑब्जेक्ट. ठीक है, थिंकर का नाम भी लिखा है, वेरी गुड. इन प्रेजेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट एज इन प्रेजेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट आई एम नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज रिटन एज दिस ग्रेटिट्यूड ऑल्सो कैन गिव सॉल्यूशंस टू मेनी ऑलमोस्ट ऑल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बाय ग्रेटिफाइंग इट्स पास्ट टूडे एंड टुमारो. ग्लोबल साउथ वर्सेस ग्लोबल नॉर्थ, gratifying past. ठीक है, so I can see that the aspirant has divided the question in three parts like I was talking, के past, present और future का लिखोगे, but you should have made separate headings for it. When there are two or three different parts in a question, you should make separate headings rather than के ऐसे ही random लिख दिया, because the examiner is going to read your answer vertically. Many toppers over the years have talked about it. So if this is the introduction, this is my part 1. And then I'll write 2 points on this. This is my part 2. So my job is not just to write the answer. My job is to ensure that my answer is such that everything is served on the platter to the examiner. ठीक है, तो सिर्फ answer लिख दिया काम नहीं चलेगा. Still, चलो अब इन्होंने तीन parts में at least divide करा है. उसके बाद ग्लोबल साउथ वर्सेस ग्लोबल नॉर्थ डिवीजन, ग्रेटिफाइंग पास्ट, मेकिंग सेंस ऑफ ज्योग्राफिकल डिवीजन. अब देखो यहाँ पे जज फॉर योरसेल्फ वेदर द पॉइंट्स रिटन हियर आर सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी और नॉट. आई एम नॉट श्योर हाउ इन व्हाट कंटेक्स्ट दिस हैज बीन रिटन, ग्लोबल साउथ वर्सेस ग्लोबल नॉर्थ, एंड व्हाट इज द कंटेक्स्ट हियर एथिक्स के पेपर में. So the answer is not self-explanatory. This is a view-based answer. This is generally what happens in a view-based answer. मैं कुछ सोचते हुए लिख रहा हूँ and I am not able to explain that holistically on the answer sheet. Now the view of the examiner and my view may or may not match. And this generally happens in applied ethics and code-based questions. इसलिए कीप इट सिंपल, कीप इट रिलेवेंट, के एक पार्ट आप पास्ट का लिखते, फिर एक प्रेजेंट का, एक फ्यूचर का, उसमें जेनरिक पॉइंट्स लिखते, ट्राई टू लिंक इट विद करंट अफेयर एग्जांपल्स एंड ऑल टू प्रूव योर व्यूज. आई एम नॉट श्योर व्हाट इज द व्यू दैट इज टेकन बाय द एस्पिरेंट. लिखा ठीक है लेकिन वो व्यू समझा नहीं पाए अपने. ठीक है, सो लेट अस रीड द नेक्स्ट आंसर. व्हाट आर द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ पब्लिक लाइफ, इलस्ट्रेट एनी थ्री ऑफ दीज विद सुटेबल एग्जांपल्स. अगेन अ पीवाईक्यू बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस. प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पब्लिक लाइफ इफ यू हैव स्टडीड, सीधा नोलान क्लिक होना चाहिए माइंड में, वेयर देर आर 7 प्रिंसिपल्स: सेल्फलेसनेस, ओपननेस, ऑब्जेक्टिविटी, ऑनेस्टी, अकाउंटेबिलिटी, इंटेग्रिटी एंड लीडरशिप. तो ये 7 प्रिंसिपल सीधा क्लिक होने चाहिए. देन यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन ओनली 3 ऑफ द 7 प्रिंसिपल्स विद सुटेबल एग्जांपल्स. सो 3 जो भी प्रिंसिपल्स लो, राइट रीसेंट एग्जांपल्स ऑफ दोज 3 रैदर देन क्लीशे एज ओल्ड एग्जांपल्स, बिकॉज दिस इज अ वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन, एनीबडी कैन आंसर इट. नाउ हाउ टू क्रिएट डिफरेंस इन योर आंसर, हाउ टू गेट दैट कंपैरेटिव एज ओवर अदर्स, इज you will be able to do that only if you present something unique, something X factor in your answer. Otherwise, everybody will get 3, 3.5 or 4 marks in this question. I want to get 5 or 5.5 or maybe 6 out of 10. So, मुझे कुछ यूनिक देना पड़ेगा. Now, let us see if the aspirant has written something unique or not. Public life is aspect of life which occurs in public, that is in open. ठीक है, public life की definition दे दिया, good. There are 7 principles, Nolan committee लिख दिया, 7 principles हो गए, good. Now, what are the basic principles of public life पूछा था, चलो सेपरेट पार्ट ही था इसलिए इतना स्पेस ऑक्यूपाई हो गया. अदरवाइज दिस डज नॉट लुक फाइन कि मैं सिर्फ एक एक वर्ड में इतनी स्पेस ले लूं. रेदर वॉट यू शुड हैव डन हियर इज सिंपल डायग्राम, जब हर क्वेश्चन में बनाना ही है, ड्रॉ 7 स्पोक्स और ड्रॉ अ माइंड मैप. यू कुड हैव told the principles as well. एक पंथ दो काज हो जाते, डायग्राम का डायग्राम और टेक्स्ट का टेक्स्ट एक साथ हो जाता. So this is a missed opportunity here in this answer with respect to drawing a diagram. अब इन्होंने 3 principles बताए होंगे, selflessness बता दिया है with example. Example देखो, age old example. So I am not saying that this example is not relevant, but then there is no X factor in this example. This is what I already stated. कि आपको कुछ नया देना है एग्जामिनर को. इफ आई एम एन एग्जामिनर एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी चेक्ड 100 कॉपीज इन डे, आई एम श्योर दीज एज ओल्ड एग्जांपल्स विल बी मेंशनड इन 30-40 कॉपीज. सो हाउ आई विल बी इंटरेस्टेड, हाउ आई विल एंड अप गिविंग मोर मार्क्स टू द कैंडिडेट अगर एग्जाम्पल्स ही नए नहीं है. नाउ लेट अस सी एग्जाम्पल फॉर ऑब्जेक्टिविटी. डेफिनेशन दे दिए उसके बाद, ठीक है. नाउ दिस इज अ करंट अफेयर एग्जाम्पल, मे बी अ करंट अफेयर और अ हाइपोथेटिकल, बट एटलीस्ट समथिंग न्यू हैज बीन रिटन इन दिस एग्जाम्पल. ठीक है, ये ऑनेस्टी पे विसल ब्लोअर का एग्जाम्पल दिया है. यू कुड हैव रिटन अदर एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर ऑनेस्टी एज वेल, पर्टिकुलरली फ्रॉम करंट अफेयर्स. एंड लास्टली कंक्लूजन, देखो वही डायग्राम मिस हुआ है एंड दिस वॉज द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू ड्रॉ द डायग्राम. सो यू हैव टू ट्रेन योर माइंड टू बी एबल टू ड्रॉ डायग्राम्स. I have tried it a lot in my courses and all, के मेरे जो students हैं वो diagrams बनाएं, and that is what is going to make difference in your answers. What is the process of strengthening moral values? Does strengthening moral values help in character building? ठीक है, अब generally होना क्या चाहिए, जब भी character का question आए you should try to link it with virtue ethics. वर्चुअल एथिक्स और कैरेक्टर, वर्चुअल एथिक्स में ये लिखा है कि वन शुड फोकस ऑन इम्बाइबिंग कैरेक्टर ट्रेट्स रेदर देन मियर प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ लॉज एंड जस्टिस. सो अब जैसी इफ आई एम एबल टू मैप कैरेक्टर विद वर्चुअल एथिक्स, वर्चुअल एथिक्स हैज 4 कार्डिनल वर्चुज. 4 कार्डिनल वर्चुज क्या है, जस्टिस, फोर्टिट्यूड, टेम्परेंस एंड प्रूडेंस. सो आई विल बी एबल टू राइट अ वेरी गुड आंसर ऑफ एथिक्स इफ in this question I am able to map these 4 values with character building. Now let us see what process the concerned aspirant has followed. So moral values is a keyword here. Moral values has been defined in the introduction. Okay, where process of strengthening moral values, ye separate heading bana diya hai, very good ki separate heading banaya hai inhone. Jaise maine bataya tha aapko ki answer will be read vertically. Process of strengthening moral values, पहला point लिखा है, begins with family's socialization. Okay, example दे दिया है. फिर teachers as guiding force, उसका example दे दिया है. उसके बाद use of reinforcements and punishment, ये Kohlberg theory से आया, reinforcement and punishment, Kohlberg moral development theory से. Exposure to positive role models, okay, उसका भी एक example दिया है. 5 point, ओके. फिफ्थ पॉइंट की इतनी नेसेसिटी नहीं थी यहाँ पे. इफ यू हैव रिटन 4 पॉइंट्स विद 1 एग्जांपल ईच, दैट इज मोर देन इनफ. एंड एनीवे दिस शुड हैव बीन अ राइडर कि मेरा पहला पेज खत्म हो गया है, लेट मी स्टॉप नाउ, लेट मी नाउ डील विद द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, क्योंकि अभी तक डायग्राम भी नहीं आया है. ठीक है, तो ओवरऑल वैसे ठीक है, बट ये मैं आपको ब्रीफ आइडिया दे रहा हूँ दैट यू शुड नो वेन टू स्टॉप अ पर्टिकुलर पार्ट ऑफ आंसर. अब यहाँ पे सेकंड पार्ट शुरू हो जाना चाहिए, डज स्ट्रेंथनिंग मॉरल वैल्यूज हेल्प इन कैरेक्टर बिल्डिंग. अब इसका देखते हैं क्या करा है इन्होंने, ये पैरा में लिखा है देखो, और ये कंक्लूजन है. अब दिस इज इन इटसेल्फ 1 पार्ट ऑफ आंसर, एंड दिस वॉज वन पार्ट ऑफ आंसर जो पूरे 1.25 पेजेस were taken to answer one part and then only half a page, less than half a page has been written on second part. So the demand of the question has not been met holistically. Even though the answer was very good for the first part, the aspirant has failed to meet the demand of the question holistically and this answer won't fetch you more than 3-3.5 marks because second part answer hi nahi hua hai theek se. Ab second part yahan pe kya likha hai inhone, let me read out. So strengthening moral values definitely helps in character building as individual with strong morality, be it acquired through experience or inherited, will be reflected in their attitude, decision making, relationships and in overall behavior. So 4 points have been written, 4 benefits of morals. Ke agar morals hai to character strong kaise hoga, only 4 points ke attitude mein reflect hoga, decision mein hoga, relationship and in overall behavior. Ye एक जेनरिक रिलेशनशिप इस्टेब्लिश हो गई है, यू आर स्टिल लेफ्ट टू प्रूव इट. और बिहेवियर कैसा होगा वो भी नहीं लिखा है, या एटीट्यूड कैसा होगा वो भी नहीं लिखा है, एटीट्यूड में रिफ्लेक्ट होगा बस वो लिखा है. नाउ नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज इट हेल्प्स इन टेकिंग टफ एंड राइट डिसीजंस ड्यूरिंग एथिकल डिलेमा यूजिंग मॉरल रीजनिंग एंड मॉरल करेज, देयरफॉर कीपिंग द इंडिविजुअल विद, ठीक है, मॉरल रीजनिंग मॉरल करेज कीवर्ड्स है, crisis of conscience keyword hai, but the answer is in para and the answer is not clear. This is what happens when you write answer in paragraph. Now instead of it, imagine if I had written 4 points that yes, moral development helps in character building because it ensures following. Pehla, justice. Second, temperance. Third, prudence. जो यहां पे इन्होंने लिखा है कि इट हेल्प्स इन टेकिंग टफ एंड राइट डिसीजन, दिस इज नथिंग बट प्रूडेंस. इन अ सेंस द आंसर ऑलरेडी यूजेस व्हाट आई टोल्ड इन द बिगनिंग इटसेल्फ, बट देन आई एम राइटिंग इट एक्सप्लिसिटली, आई हैव सर्विंग इट ऑन द प्लेटर टू द एग्जामिनर एंड दिस इज व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन यूपीएससी. सो आई विल राइट 4 पॉइंट्स, 1 पॉइंट ईच. And then for any of them or maybe a combined example in the end. So example is also missing in this part of answer. This is not going to fetch you more than 3 marks even if you have written decent keywords and all. Next is, if a country is to be corruption free and become a nation of beautiful minds, I strongly feel there are 3 key societal members who can make a difference. They are the father, the mother and the teacher. Ye, if I remember it correctly, this was asked in 2017 mains and this question was repeated in 21 or 22 as well. Exact question has been asked twice by UPSC, if I remember this correctly. So the question, the keyword here is, actually the question is from a topic, that is role of parents, role of school, role of teachers in value development. Syllabus ka hi topic hai, human values chapter se seedha seedha book se question hai ye. Kisi bhi book pe aapko ye topic mil jayega. Ab karna kya hai ke you will split the question in 3 parts and you will write the role. What is the role of the father? What is the role of the mother? What is the role of the teacher to ensure that the country is of beautiful minds and it is corruption free. So I'll explain the role of the father in 1 point and I'll then link it with the demand of the topic, that how if a father does his role perfectly, then the country will be of beautiful mind and corruption free. If the mother does the role honestly, then the nation will be of beautiful minds and corruption free. Aise similarly with teacher, and I'll write one example either for each, if I am able to have different unique examples from current affairs or from historical evident personalities, I'll write one example of a good father, good mother, good teacher. Otherwise, if you do not have unique examples, you can write 2 generic examples in the end. Now let us see what this aspirant has done. So Milton Rockwich use kara hai to define what is values. Even though value is not a direct keyword in the question, but ye keyword se link kara hai inhone, theek hai, nothing wrong in it. Role of parents ko dekho, ab club kar diya. So this is what I told in the beginning ke रोल ऑफ फादर एंड रोल ऑफ मदर को रोल ऑफ पेरेंट्स में क्लब कर दिया. एंड जनरली व्हेन यू डू दैट यू ओनली एंड अप राइटिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू रोल ऑफ मदर. फादर इग्नोर ही हो जाएगा इसमें मोस्ट लाइकली. इस आंसर में भी यही होगा. मैंने आंसर भी पढ़ा नहीं है. लेट अस फाइंड आउट कि ऐसा हुआ या नहीं. सो रोल ऑफ पेरेंट्स, मदर पहला पॉइंट है. चलो टू बी अ डिसिप्लिन पर्सन इफ फादर इज डिसिप्लिन. शुक्र है फादर के बारे में लिखा है यहाँ पे, अदरवाइज इट हैपेंस. नाउ व्हाट आई विल रैदर डू इज के आई विल डिवाइड इट इन टू पार्ट्स रैदर देन राइटिंग देम सेपरेटली. एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू सी दिस एग्जाम्पल. This is an example that I gave in my module as well. UP board topper, the girl was trolled on social media, but the other day or in 2 days time, the girl stated that the issue did not affect her because she has been brought up as such, that such issues do not matter to her. Theek hai, I'm happy to see this example here. रोल ऑफ टीचर्स में लीडरशिप क्वालिटीज, कौटिल्य, करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज, कॉन्फिडेंस इन चिल्ड्रेन. बट अब देखो डिमांड ऑफ क्वेश्चन से लिंक नहीं हो रहा है. हाउ वेयर इज करप्शन एड्रेस्ड इन दिस क्वेश्चन, लेट अस नाउ फाइंड दैट. सो मदर इज फर्स्ट टीचर, करप्शन एड्रेस नहीं हुआ. फिर टू बी अ डिसिप्लिन पर्सन, डिसिप्लिन से चलो स्टिल, बट डायरेक्टली ऑन द प्लेटर, सर्विंग ऑन द प्लेटर, करप्शन और ब्यूटिफुल माइंड हैज नॉट बीन एड्रेस्ड. गिविंग इनर पीस टू पर्सन, हेयर ऑल्सो करप्शन हैज नॉट बीन एड्रेस्ड. टॉक डिस्कशन टू सॉल्व एनी प्रॉब्लम, करप्शन, ब्यूटिफुल माइंड नॉट एड्रेस्ड. टीच लीडरशिप क्वालिटीज, नॉट एड्रेस्ड. लर्न थ्रू करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज, अगेन गेम्स एटसेट्रा. जेनरिक आंसर है. What this aspirant has basically done is नोट से थ्योरी से उठाया और वो थ्योरी लिख दी आंसर में, believing that you have been able to meet the demand of the question, but you are completely wrong here. I will not give you more than 2 marks, even though you have drawn a good diagram, decision chart diagram बनाया है, you have written conclusion, you have divided in sub parts, but you have completely failed to meet the demand of the question. If a country is to be corruption free and become a nation of beautiful mind, strongly feel that 3 key societal members, you have written generic points with respect to the societal members. ठीक है, let us see the next question. Describe and discuss the ethical issues involved in the use of online methodology, particularly to the vulnerable section of the society. Okay, again a question, this is an applied ethics based question that was asked in mains. A tough question, because highly likely that if you are not aware about how to answer applied ethics questions, you will end up writing generic answer here. You will make an answer of GS2 rather than GS4. This question has been asked in ethics. Mujhe answer mein ethics chahiye, varna marks nahi aayenge. Or I have already predicted that there will be at least 5 or 6 questions of applied ethics in 2024 mains. Because 2023 paper was completely theoretical. 9 out of 13 questions were directly from any given theory. It was very easy paper. So, is by 24 mein tough aayega. And this has been the cycle that UPSC has followed. Odd even year ki cycle ho rahi hai. If you have analyzed last 5 years, you will know that ek saal theoretical aata hai, ek saal applied ethics aata hai. Now, you will get applied ethics question. So, let us see. Yahan kya answer kar hai applied ethics ka. Vulnerable section of society were benefited as well as trapped by online methodology. Very generic introduction. Very generic. This is not the sort of introduction that is expected in ethics answer. Now let me first tell you what I'll write in this answer. Trust me, I have not seen the answer. I'm discussing it live. So describe and discuss the ethical issues involved in use of online methodology, particularly to the vulnerable section of society. Online methodology, now let me try to bring a implicit keyword here. Online methodology kya hota hai? E-governance is part of your syllabus. It is exclusively mentioned as part of syllabus in ethics paper, e-governance. So I'll start my answer with e-governance and I'll link it with online methodology. So what I'll say is e-governance makes use of online methodology to ensure that even the last man standing in the last row is being served, or to ensure that our society is such that no one falls through the cracks of society and voices of even the marginalized are heard in line with Bible traditions. तो क्या हुआ, आई हैव नॉट ओनली इंटीग्रेटेड द सिलेबस, आई हैव इंटीग्रेटेड द कीवर्ड मेंशन्ड हियर ऑनलाइन मेथोडोलॉजी एंड आई हैव ऑल्सो इंटीग्रेटेड अ रिलीजियस थीम दैट इज बाइबल एथिक्स. सो अब आप खुद कंपेयर कर सकते हो जेनरिक इंट्रोडक्शन से वो इंट्रोडक्शन कितना अलग है. नाउ लेट अस सी द पॉइंट्स, डिस्क्राइब एंड डिस्कस एथिकल इशूज. सो यू हैव टू मेंशन एथिकल इशूज ऑफ ऑनलाइन मेथोडोलॉजी पर्टिकुलरली टू द वल्नरेबल सेक्शन ऑफ सोसाइटी. Impact of online methodology on tribals, on rural people, or is there anything with respect to caste and class ke online methodology, whether it is excluding them, old senior citizens, yeah, women, yeah, children, these are the vulnerable sections of society. So you have to try to bring them in answer somewhere or other. Let us see. Sometimes the application of which committed to provide best quality product distracted and harmed the person with less knowledge by providing false. I am not able to make sense, but overall gist is clear, but the sentence is not making any sense as such. The data of online methodology is not much protected, so using data of vulnerable section, the hackers tend to cause. ठीक है, I'm not able to read. मैं sense समझ गया हूँ कि ये data protection की बात हो रही है इसमें, यहाँ पे quality की बात हो रही है and maybe about digital illiteracy. But till now I have not been able to find keywords in the answer. Online teaching and learning benefited a lot to vulnerable section as they avail the facility of best teaching. Beside, it is also true that they lost their habit of meeting different people and can become deviated from path of morality, righteousness in the heart. Some become addicted to more online, causing eye damage. Ye toh bahut hi, this is unacceptable point in ethics paper. You cannot write such generic points in ethics paper. Online methodology makes self-sufficient and unsocial. ठीक है, what I'll rather write in this question is के how is online methodology able to serve utilitarianism or not? Whether it is serving the principle of last man standing in the last row or not? I'll write keywords like online bias, digital bias, stereotypes, prejudice. These are part of your syllabus. Stereotypes and prejudice, I have taught them in attitude class. So stereotypes or prejudice pe ek point ban jayega, ek point utilitarian pe ban gaya. You can write about privacy, piracy, you can write about digital theft, online abuse, cyber trolling, etc., etc. You can write in this answer, but I cannot see any such keyword so far. The wahi maine jo shuru mein bola tha, this is the challenge with respect to applied ethics question. If you write generic answers, you will not get marks and there is no diagram as well. So try to integrate ethics even in applied ethics question. I am expecting 4 to 5 questions in 2024 mains. Next is attitude is little thing that makes a big difference with respect to successful implementation of government schemes. Okay. सो एटीट्यूड वैसे तो छोटा है अपने आप में, इतना कोई इंपॉर्टेंट चीज नहीं है, बट इट कैन मेक ह्यूज डिफरेंस विद रिस्पेक्ट टू इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ गवर्नमेंट स्कीम. व्हाट आई कैन डू इज आई कैन डिवाइड इट इन टू पार्ट्स, वेयर नेगेटिव एटीट्यूड लेड टू पुअर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ अ स्कीम एंड वेयर पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड लेड टू पुअर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन गुड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ स्कीम. सो positive attitude not only with respect to bureaucrats but also citizens, negative attitude not just with respect to bureaucrats but citizens as well. So now I can have two parts of question. I can write 2 points each, jisme ek point ho jayega bureaucratic attitude, ek point ho jayega civilian attitude, and I can write a good example as well. For example, when the demonetization policy was brought, it was brought with good intentions. But then the public in the beginning was very hesitant. It was averse to the policy. That was because of negative attitude. So negative attitude created hurdles in implementation of policy in the beginning. Whereas now, in the positive example, you can mention about good implementation of Swachh Bharat scheme, that the government tried to change not only the behavior, but also the attitude of the masses. And it clearly reflects in good implementation of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan in cities like Indore, which is topping Swachh Sarvekshan survey from the last 5, 6, 7 years. दो examples यदि मैंने आपको दो part हो गए, very easily this question can be answered. Attitude is a keyword that has to be defined in introduction. Now let us see what is the answer. Attitude is evaluation of particular, ठीक है, keyword define कर दिया है. Attitude of a state. The answer is in paragraph. ठीक है, let us read. If a state's attitude streamlined with democratic attitude, then it will treat their people as, ये short forms ऐसे नहीं लिखते भाई paper में, important पूरा लिखना होता है, important stakeholders, and will make them active participant in governance. It will understand what people want and what their actual needs and applicability in that particular socio-economic settings. और एग्जाम्पल दे दिया, ठीक है, आंसर इज फाइन, बट देन इट इज इन पैराग्राफ, स्टिल इट इज फाइन. और एक एग्जाम्पल दे दिया है विद रिस्पेक्ट टू सक्सेसफुल स्कीम्स लाइक दिस दिस दिस. इतनी स्कीम्स लिखने की जरूरत नहीं थी, यू कुड हैव रिटन ओनली वन और टू. दिस इज नॉट जीएस पेपर के आप पूरी स्कीम्स ऐसे इतने सारे बता रहे हो. दीज स्कीम्स नॉलेज, एक्चुअली इट इज वेस्ट ऑफ स्पेस, नथिंग एल्स. ये वेस्ट ऑफ स्पेस है, इसका कोई रोल नहीं आपके आंसर में. इफ यू हैव told ethics keywords, you have written one or two example, that is more than enough. The examiner understands that you have met the demand of the question. This is actually not the demand ki main various schemes likhun, this is not GS2. Uske baad bureaucratic attitude, pehle upar ho gaya tha, democratic attitude se link kara inhone, fir bureaucratic attitude. These are the keywords of previous year questions. I guess this question was asked in 2014 or 15. What is difference between bureaucratic and democratic attitude? Ab isme likha hai bureaucratic attitude. It is just the mirror of state's attitude towards policies and programs. But successful implementation also depends on administrators' fine balance with moral attitude. Like, theek hai, points mein samajh gaya hun, but still, see, the issue with writing answer in paragraph, you are digressing from the demand. If I had written this in points form, I would have straight away started with the point that I want to mention. And hence, I'll be able to write two good points with one example, because I'll not digress from the demand of that question. Okay, overall, the approach is fine. Democratic versus bureaucratic attitude. But सिविलियन एस्पेक्ट में नहीं लिखा है. द एस्पेक्ट दैट हैव बीन लार्जली रिटन आर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ब्यूरोक्रेट्स. यू कुड हैव डिवाइडेड दिस इन टू पार्ट्स, लाइक आई हैड टोल्ड के एक पॉजिटिव बता दो, एक नेगेटिव बता दो, एंड ओवरऑल द अप्रोच इज फाइन. लास्ट है, human beings should always be treated as end in themselves and never as means. Explain the meaning and significance of this statement, giving its implication in modern techno-economic society. Again, a previous year question, applied ethics based question. So this is a applied ethics based question that has to be linked with theory. Ab ye question padhte hi, it should click in your mind that CI2, that is the categorical imperative 2 of Kant, says the same thing. And now that I know ke CI2 mein likha hai, I'll mention the keywords of theory here. So is answer mein CI2 aana chahiye, is answer mein Kant aayega, is answer mein keywords aayenge us theory ke, inherent worth, inherent rights by being human, etc., etc. aise keywords isme aane chahiye. Now let us see ke aaya hai nahi. Theek hai, intro is good. Intro is started with Immanuel Kant, encapsulate ethical principle that individual should be respected. CI2 नहीं लिखा है यहाँ पे, इन्होंने बस ये लिखा है कि above statement is by Immanuel Kant. यहाँ पे कैटेगोरिकल इम्पेरेटिव्स आने चाहिए थे और यहाँ पे स्पेसिफिकली आना चाहिए था दैट दिस इज CI2। नाउ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन दैट एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग एंड सिग्निफिकेंस, फिर इम्प्लीकेशन इन मॉडर्न टेक्नो इकोनॉमिक सोसाइटी। सो सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ ट्रीटिंग एज एंड्स एंड नॉट मीन्स, वेरी गुड यूजेज ऑफ डायग्राम। थ्योरी का थ्योरी हो गया, पूरा पार्ट एड्रेस हो गया सिग्निफिकेंस का, और अपने कीवर्ड्स भी आ गए, डायग्राम भी हो गया, गुड। नेक्स्ट इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन दैट इज इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ अबव स्टेटमेंट इन मॉडर्न टेक्नो इकोनॉमिक सोसाइटी। सो चाइल्ड लेबर, टेक यूज टू एक्सप्लॉइट चाइल्ड लेबर फॉर इकोनॉमिक गेन्स, चिल्ड्रेन माइनिंग कोबाल्ट फॉर, थोड़ा इनडायरेक्ट है, देर आर एन नंबर ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल थिंग्स दैट कुड हैव बीन रिटन हियर, लाइक सरोगेसी, एबॉर्शन और इवन यूथनेशिया, ठीक है, और द डिजिटल मीडियम, सोशल मीडिया, दैट इज ऑल्सो टेक्नोलॉजिकल स्फेयर वेयर ह्यूमन आर यूज एज मीन्स रैदर देन एंड्स। So rather than trying to integrate child labor, which is very far-fetched to be honest in this answer, you could have used a simpler point. Uske baad factory working conditions, caste-based discrimination, theek hai, I am not sure, wahi hai fir mera view aur aapka view isme match nahi ho raha hai. You have written points, I can see keywords, but these are too far-fetched. I could have written the answer very easily, techno, jaise maine spheres aapko bataya, you could have written about economic sphere, 2 points and one good example. Anyway, if you count the words that you have used, I am sure you have crossed the word limit of 150. Wo isi page pe cross ho jayega, I am 100% sure. There is no space whatsoever left in your answer, and I am sure you have taken more than 7 minutes to write this, and the word limit has been crossed as well. Because why I am so sure about it? Because if you follow this approach, this is the introduction of 30 words, then a heading, then 2 points of 2 line each, one example of 2 line, then the second part of the question, that is second heading, 1 and 2 points, example 2, diagram and a conclusion. This itself takes 140 to 150 words. Aapko yakin nahi ho raha to dekho, 30 words intro, 15 to 20 words, 15 to 20 words, 15 to 20 words example, again 15 to 20. So 15 to 20 into 6 is 90 to 120 words of 90 to 120 words will be occupied in 4 points and 2 examples, plus 30, plus 30, ye iske. So 90 plus 60 is 150. So even in this approach, even if I am taking only the lower side of it, isi mein 150 words complete ho jayenge. So I am 100% sure, ye to 250, 300 cross ho raha hai. So however good the answer appears to be, I am sure you know about the penalty marks as well, that UPSC gives penalty marks in mains paper for crossing word limits, for revealing your identity, etc. So overall, I discussed 11-12 answers. In few of the answers, I could find relevant points, keywords. Diagrams have largely been missed out, and unfortunately, those who have drawn diagrams, they have not been able to meet demand of the question. Those who have met the demand of the question, they have not drawn diagrams and have not written new and relevant examples. So ethics appears to be a low hanging fruit, but then as you would have seen it here, it is not that easy as it appears to be. I'll bring up more evaluation sessions in similar lines. If you have any doubts, you can tune into the description section and find relevant links to ask your doubts. Thank you.